others who would like to share thoughts at this time. Amazing to see everybody out here. So, my name is Seymour Josephson. I'm Samantha's father. Can I see a show of hands of how many people actually knew her? Wow. The reason I ask that is that there are so many people here that did not know her in this community that has pulled together. It's totally amazing. The Gamecocks, USC, your people, how you guys have come together, how you pulled this together, the support that you guys have. The support of the university has been tremendous to us, to our friends, to our family. It's funny, everybody has what we call Sammyisms. Now, you think it was just you. Over the last several days, we all have these Sammyisms where, like, it becomes almost weekly. Daily, sometimes. She gets on these little rolls. So, as it was stated that Samantha was going to go to law school, she was just put her deposit down, actually, Thursday? So, we had student acceptance day the weekend before, so she was home. We got to spend some time with her. We were supposed to come down today, actually, to surprise her as a visit. My wife and I. So we're going to be here today, tomorrow, and Tuesday. So she came home. She went to Drexel for student acceptance day. And she tells the story that one of our best friends, Barb, her son goes to Drexel Law. And she was telling the story. I'm going to screw this up, I'm sorry. But she tells the story of that she met so many teachers there, so many different people, so many dean, and so she goes, Barb goes, who did you meet? She goes, I met Dean whatever. She goes, there were so many deans. Barb looks at her and goes, do you mean dean of whatever that, he was the dean of that particular part of the school. She thought his name was Dean. So many games. So that's just one little thing of Sam. She had a lot of nicknames. I had called her Sam, Sammy, Sambo, Samantha, Jackass, yeah. Dumbass, PA. Both my kids knew that. But in all honesty, guys, there's no words that my family and I and friends can express to you guys. The one thing that I will tell you that has come out of this, and the one thing that I have been saying, and we've had so many requests for interviews, and I haven't wanted to do any interviews whatsoever. It's not about me, it's really about Samantha. But we started talking, and the group, and we were like, what happened, right? What happened that this all happened and why we're here? So I did two interviews, not even interviews, statements, basically, on the phone today. And it is because what I want to get out there, and it's about you guys. You guys take Ubers, take Lyft, and I wanted to single them out, but Uber was what Sammy had on her phone, on my credit card. Hers never worked. So she said. So she had the Uber, she called the Uber, had the black car, license plate, the name. She went up to one Uber, and then it wasn't right, that Uber's a no, so she went back. Went in, she saw another black car pulled up, and so she jumped into it. Opened the door, the guy said, whatever, I don't know. She jumped in. She was by herself, right? And this is not that different than you guys. What we have learned is that you cannot, men or women, you guys have to travel together. At night, let's be honest, you guys are drinking, leaving the bar, or whatever it may be. You get into an Uber, you don't know if it's an Uber. You don't know anything about it. If there's two of you, something less likely will happen. Samantha was by herself. She had absolutely no chance. None. The door was locked. The child safety lock was on. She had absolutely no chance in this. If there's somebody else in the car, there's actually a chance. So what I want to do is educate everybody, and not that I'm the smartest person here, but I've gone through this, and I don't want anybody else to ever go through this again. I can't tell you how painful this is. But you leave a bar. We're all drinking. We're in one drink, two drinks, whatever drinks. You're not thinking as clearly. You'll want to get home. So, in the interview was partly that. The other part is taking on Uber, taking on Lyft. What else can they do to help and enhance the safety of the client, right? You have the Uber driver, then you have the client. It's really about taking that on and what they can do to change and to help keep you guys safe, keeping the public safe. I've taken Uber. I travel. I take Uber, but I'm also 6'2", whatever poundage, which I'm not going to tell you. I'm not worried about myself. Not many people are going to mess with me. I'm happy. I'm okay. If somebody smaller, female, it's different. Females, it's different. So that is going to be part of my mission in life now, is going around talking, if I can. Educating, getting that out, and hopefully putting pressure on Uber and Lyft to change something, to make it enhancements. So with that said, I really want to thank you once again from the Josephson family, from our friends, and I want to thank you students that have impacted her. She absolutely loved it here. She was a Gamecock. And the university has been great. So, with that, I just want to say, go Gamecocks.